fue ya 2 años pasados, yo creo que ya hay de lo positivo.
Good. You know, I think it's been easier to process this go around because I went through the same process 2 years ago. So I feel a little, I've been feeling a little more positive.
When we talked to you with Eddie, you mentioned, you know, being optimistic that it wasn't an ACL tear. How surprised were you when you got back the results?
La verdad que me sorprendió bastante porque al final uno es el que sabe, uno es el que siente los dolores de su cuerpo. Yo decía que es más o menos común, pero nunca pensé que tenía el ligamento roto.
Yeah, I was fairly surprised, you know, because obviously it's your body, you're the one kind of feeling through the pains, and you know, that was sort of what it felt like. It felt like I was probably going to be out for that duration that I said, but yeah, I was surprised to hear that it was torn.
Do you think there's anything you'll be able to do, I don't know, differently when you come back? Or is this, I mean, you play hard, obviously. You cut hard, you run hard. Will there be anything you can do to maybe decrease the chances of it happening again?
Que si tú anticipas que va a cambiar la manera como juega para evitar esto que pase otra vez.
No voy a cambiar nada. Yo creo que esa es la esencia mía. Esa es la manera en que yo juego y esa es la manera que yo voy a seguir jugando. Solamente queda recuperarme fuerte, lo suficiente para volver y seguir jugando duro y seguir robando base.
No, I don't think so. I think that's kind of the essence of who I am. You know, all the stuff for me to do right now is just put in the work, coming stronger, hopefully, than I was before. And but if I might, you know, I'm going to keep playing the way that I'm playing because that's my game and that's who I am. And so when I come back, I hope to, you know, keep stealing bases and keep playing hard on the field.
Ronald, what kind of support have you received from your teammates, from coaching staff?
No, increíble todo el apoyo que me han dado, de verdad que increíble todo el apoyo. Todos mis compañeros, los fanáticos, toda la organización, de verdad que he llorado muchas veces en la casa por eso, porque al final soy el que lo estaba abandonando, pero nada, hay que seguir positivo y yo recuerdo la última vez que me lesioné, quedamos campeón.
It's incredible, the amount of support has been absolutely incredible from teammates, to the coaches, the fans, the entire organization, you know. Honestly, it's the amount of support has been overwhelming. It's that all that support is, you know, it finds me crying at home by myself, you know. And the reason that's happening is, you know, it's because I feel like I'm the one abandoning the team. You know, it feels like I'm the one letting everyone down. But there's nothing I can do, you know, just continue to work hard, continue to heal. And, you know, the last time this happened, the team won a World Series. So that's the goal right there.
Have you been able to talk to anyone who's had it on both knees? I don't think there are many instances. I know Wilson Ramos, I believe, is one example of a player who had both knees.
Si hablaba con un pelotero que le han operado unas dos rodillas para eso en particular.
No he hablado, pero yo pasé por eso, me entiendes, es el mismo proceso, solamente hay que seguir positivo, hay que seguir trabajando fuerte, es bastante doloroso la rehabilitación. Me duele más la rehabilitación que la operación, pero nada, yo creo que eso es parte del proceso y hay que seguir adelante.
No, haven't talked to anyone, but fortunately for me it feels like, since I've already been through it, I kind of know what to expect. And it should be a similar process in that sense, and you know, it's painful. I'm not going to dance around it. You know, it feels like the rehab is probably the most painful part of, even more painful than the operation. But there's nothing else to do except just, you know, to take it, continue to work hard, move forward.
When's the surgery been set?
La fecha de la operación.
Tuesday.
What did you learn about the rehab last time in terms of getting through it mentally that you'll take into this one?
Algo que aprendiste la última vez que tuviste que hacer todo eso, en particular con la mentalidad.
Mira, yo creo que aprendí a ser más fuerte de lo que soy, y yo creo que si uno quiere la cima, uno tiene que aceptarle el precio de la subida.
You know, a lot, and I think, you know, I think I just learned that I was stronger than what I really knew, than what I knew about myself. And you know, if you want the ultimate goal, you got to pay the price to get there.
Who have you heard from outside the organization? Has there just been overwhelming support from other people too in baseball and maybe even other sports?
Si hay alguien en particular que se ha comunicado contigo, dándote apoyo.
No, sí, mucho pelotero, la mayoría de los peloteros me mandaron su deseo, ¿verdad? Que siempre me tienen sus oraciones, muchos atletas de otros deportes también, de verdad, pero no, O sea, yo veo los mensajes, pero casi no le respondo porque me da mucha ganas de llorar, ¿entiendes? Entonces yo creo que es algo sentimental, porque yo sé que ellos me quieren ver bien así como yo a ellos y es un poco difícil.
Lots of people, lots of volleyball players throughout the league, other athletes from other sports, and so it's been an overwhelming amount of support and people that have reached out to me. And to be honest, you know, I haven't gotten around to replying a lot of those messages just because those messages come from, you know, a place of support, and every time I start reading them, I sort of break down and start crying. So I know that all these guys who are reaching out to me, they just want what's best for me. They want to see me be healthy and do well, just as I want the same for them. And so that's why it's overwhelming.
Ronald, I remember you saying last time that it was really hard for you just to even sit and watch the game. You kind of went through a little bit of a depression. So what did you learn about yourself maybe to overcome that? I know you've been through it before, but also did anyone specifically help you or lean on them during that time?
Que si alguien particular te ayudó, la última vez que mencionaste que te dio esta dificultad ver los juegos, que si alguien te ayudó ahí en ese proceso.
La familia, yo creo que la familia es lo más importante cuando uno está pasando este proceso. Yo creo que tener su familia ahí al lado todos los días. Yo creo que ese apoyo de la madre, de tu padre, de tu hijo. Yo creo que eso es lo que te ayuda a seguir fuerte.
The family's been the big difference maker. You know, having your family there every single day. Know your mom, your parents, your kids, having your family there every day, I think has been just the real sort of key.
How much joy have Ronald and Jamal brought you since, you know, having them around?
La alegría que tener tu hijo ahí alrededor de ustedes durante este proceso entero.
Mira, verdad que es increíble porque a veces yo en la casa cuando tú me llevas unos días atrás, de verdad, ellos se estaban riendo porque somos unos niños, no saben lo que están pasando, pero verdad que eso me hace seguir siendo fuerte. Yo creo que mi familia es la razón por que hoy en día yo estoy aquí.
A lot, you know, even the other day, you know, when I was at home, I, you know, found myself crying and I look over and they're laughing. You know, they don't know any different, they're kids. But just being able to see them laugh like that and just have a family around, you know, it helps keep you, you know, it's what you're doing it for, and that's what helps you get through it.
Well, you, the time, I know they haven't set a timetable, but in your head, will you be aiming for opening day next year, given when it happened, or and how long it took before, or what are you thinking?
O sea, si va a estar listo para el opening day el año que viene, o qué te estás pensando?
Mira, en mi mente, yo creo que ojalá y con el favor de Dios todo salga bien, la recuperación vaya bien y me mantenga fuerte, y eso no sé cuándo volveré a jugar, pero cuando el equipo me diga que puedo jugar, pues ya nosotros no tendremos oportunidad.
I'm just hopeful that, you know, the surgery goes well, the rehab goes well, and that, you know, everything goes according to plan. And as far as, you know, the return, I'll be ready when the team says I'm ready. And until then, you know, more opportunities for other guys to play.
What did you learn about that first season back from last time that you'll apply next year when you came back to play
in 2022? Sí, que aprendí después. La primera temporada, después de que te recuperaste la primera operación y del reto de que vas a estar ahí con las rodillas nuevas, obviamente.
Pero yo creo que la paciencia y esperar todo su tiempo, porque a lo mejor quizás en la primera operación yo estaba un poco apresurado por las ansias, las ganas de salir a jugar, pero yo creo que en esta primero me voy a poner fuerte y cuando le digo vida que puedo jugar, ahí estaré.
Patience, I think that's the first thing that I would take away from the last go around. You know, it felt like I was antsy and anxious to get back on the field, and I felt, you know, very just excited to kind of go back to play. And so for this go around, you know, I'm just gonna let things develop how they're supposed to. I'm gonna continue to work hard, train, rehab, get stronger, and then when the team says I'm ready to go, I'll be ready to go.
Ronald, how can you use, you're such a competitor, right? And the rehab process can be a grind. So do you find yourself still using your competitive side maybe through the rehab process? What kind of helps you still get that going through this tough time?
Que si tú te encuentras así, tomando ventaja o aprovechando de ¿cómo te digo? Ser competitivo así y usar eso para seguir mejorando y la actitud que tú haces con el rehab.
No, yo creo que eso ya vive dentro de mí, eso viene conmigo, la confianza. Yo creo que es bueno también que uno pase por eso, porque a veces es bueno perderse para volver a encontrarse, ¿me entiendes? Y yo creo que si estas cosas me están pasando por el propósito,
you know, I think that confidence, that competitive nature is something innate, and I think it's just, that's who I am, and so I don't think there's any, you know, extra thing to it. And, you know, sometimes these things are blessings in disguise. You know, sometimes you got to lose yourself to find yourself. And I think that's how I'm trying to approach this thing. I just, I'm going to take everything in stride. And, you know, like I said, it's another opportunity. And who knows? Maybe I can come back and win another MVP.
Well, when you guys lost Spencer earlier this year, when we talked to him, he said that rehab process, he doesn't want to just come back. He wants to come back and be better. How do you think that you can come back and be better? Where can you find a way to improve after finishing this process?
Sí, que usted mencionó que cuando se recupere de esta operación quiere regresar, no como el lanzador que era, pero como un lanzador mejor. ¿Cómo tú puedes más o menos decir la misma cosa? O sea, ¿cuáles son las metas tuyas de regresar más fuerte?
No, entrenar todos los días, haciendo todas las cosas que me di la coaching extra, el médico, que todas las cosas. Si hay que trabajar extra, voy a trabajar extra, porque yo sé la capacidad que uno tiene para volver más fuerte. Y de verdad que espero volver como un mejor pelotero, como una mejor persona. No como el pelotero del 2023, quiero volver mejor, y tengo todo el tiempo para hacerlo.
Same, yeah, and I just, to me, the way you do that is just by doing everything the coaches tell you to do, the training staff tells you to do, the medical staff tell you to do, and just come in and put in the work and put in the extra work and, you know, focus on doing all things the right way. And, you know, my goal is to come back a better player, a better person. I would say I want to come back a better player than I was in 2023.
Do you think of yourself as unlucky?
¿Tú crees que tú tienes mala suerte?
No, yo creo que yo juego muy duro.
No, I think I just play hard.
Hey, Ronald, I have to imagine it being rather difficult being around your teammates every second of every day during the season, and then something like this happens, and you'll be doing rehab and other things, but how much of an emphasis will you place on still being around this team throughout this run?
Sí, que obviamente te tienes que enfocar en tu recuperación y el rehab y todo eso, pero si vas a tener un enfoque de estar alrededor del equipo y apoyar a tus compañeros durante el resto de la temporada.
No, claro. Yo voy a estar en Los Ángeles por un mes y medio, dos meses haciendo el rehab, y cuando vuelva voy a hacer mi rehab aquí y apoyar a mis compañeros todos los días en el duro.
Oh, yes, of course. I mean, definitely. You know, I'm going to be in Los Angeles for a month, month and a half or whatever, and then when I come back and just start doing my rehab here, I'm going to be here every night, you know, supporting my teammates every game.
I know you've really liked playing winter ball. Is that something you'll continue to do after the rehab process?
Obviamente has disfrutado jugar la Liga Invernal, pero si tú crees que eso es algo que vas a hacer después que te recuperes del proceso.
Bueno, este año no creo, porque tengo que recuperarme primero y volver el año que viene como tengo que volver. Y quizás en el 2025, a final de la temporada, pueda que juegue, porque viene el clásico en el 2026. Espero que todo vaya bien en salud. Puedo hacer.
Not this year, obviously, because I'm focusing on the recovery and everything like that. But come, you know, the end of 2025, if everything is sort of going well, and if I'm feeling good, and, you know, obviously the World Baseball Classic's around the corner as well. So, yeah, I mean, we'll see. But
when you mentioned the World Series the last time it happened with your injury, and it's somewhat a joking way, but do you believe with the injuries that this team has battled that this team is still competitive to win another World Series title?
Por algo estamos aquí, ¿no? Yo creo que por algo todos los que estamos en este equipo tenemos un propósito. Ellos no me necesitan a mí para ganar una serie mundial. Nosotros tenemos tremendo equipo.
We're here for a reason. Every player on that roster over there is there for a reason. This team is completely capable of. They don't need me to win the World Series. Gracias, Ronald.